What is up, everybody? Larry here, F.U.C. Just got back, well, actually, a couple days ago from Texas Frightmare Weekend 2019 over in Dallas, DFW, which is actually only an hour and a half from me. Less than an hour and a half, actually. Amazing time. It was my third year in a row going. You know, if you ever have a chance to go, make sure you go. First off, I don't really vlog. I'm not a big vlogger. I'd rather like experience the convention more, or I should say experience hanging out with my friends. So after this video is over with, where I'm going to show you some cool stuff I picked up at TFW, stay on and look at all the pictures that I took, though, because we do have a lot of pictures. I guess I took a lot of pictures. I do have a lot of videos, but they are not YouTube friendly, I guess. They're more private videos for me and my friends and stuff and people that were with us. And we had a good fun time partying it up. But, yeah, so of course, this year I went down there with my buddies, Darren over at Horror and Me. Got Jordan, Horrorhound 85, and Paul, Slasher Junkie. Y'all make sure y'all go subscribe to their pages. Awesome, awesome dudes. Some fucking great friends of mine. And it was a blast. Got to see a lot of my old friends that I've been hanging out with for the past couple years. It was really good to see them again. I would name all of them too, but if I miss one person's name, I don't want them to feel bad because it would be a total accident. For everybody new I met, people that I kind of knew, but met them for the first time in real life, amazing to meet them. And for everybody who I had no clue who the hell they were, and we ended up all becoming friends by the end of the con. I think by the time I got home from TFW, that 2.5 day weekend really, I think I had 20 new Facebook friends, about 50 new Instagram followers, and about probably 30 new YouTube subscribers. And the funny thing is, I didn't even tell anybody about anything I did. So it was just cool. You start talking to somebody, you meet them, and y'all click. And so you tell them your name. Holy shit. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, it's funny, you know, when you tell the kids, hey, give me 10 minutes. Don't come in here. Whatever you do, do not come in here. What's the first thing that happens? Here comes one, right away. Anyways, let me get back to where I was. Everybody that I met, fun times. Thank y'all for an amazing time. Half of it I probably don't really remember because we were a little inebriated. But yeah, that's what makes it fun. So at the convention, there was a lot of big celebrities there this year. More than normal for like bigger name celebrities. Tried to meet as many as I could. I'll show you a couple things. We did a couple photo ops. Of course, if you haven't seen, if you're not friends with me on Facebook, first off, and you want to be friends on Facebook, just hit me up. Larry Marek, M-A-R-E-K. I'll accept you. But you can see my pictures on there too. Me and Darren did a cosplay as Tucker and Dale. So this is our photo op that we did with Tim Curry. And you can't really see it on here probably, but me and Tucker and Dale were dressed up, you know. Which I think actually made the picture better. Then we did one a little later with Robert Englund, Mr. Freddy Krueger. And since Darren wasn't in this one, and I was still dressed up, it kind of just made me look like an old dirty hobo standing in the background. But that's all right. Couple things I picked up. You don't know the clay guy. I mean, you should know the clay guy. Makes awesome figures. I saw this one, had to snag it. This is Street Trash. Got the Viper bottle down there. Fucking melting away down to the toilet. That's a badass figure. This is number what? 10 of 100, I'm guessing. Very cool. it's only the second clay guy figure I have, so I was happy to get it. Met Jonathan Brick, the creeper. I already had this mask. It was back on my shelf. I just pulled it off and took it. This dude is amazing, cool ass dude to talk to. He was sit there and bullshit. See if I can figure this out. He signed the top of the head in like this bright pink marker, which is actually very cool. I wouldn't have ever thought or told somebody to sign it in pink, but he's like, hey, let me try this marker, because I guess he hadn't used it. And it came out looking amazing. And I might see if people can start signing it like that now, from now on, because it really pops. Next, Meatloaf. For y'all that don't know, Meatloaf was at the convention, kind of. He was doing like a Q&A session on Friday when the con first pretty much opened, and tripped and fell off the stage and broke his collarbone. So he wasn't really at the con for the most part, but he had some pre-signed drum heads for sale. So I definitely scooped them up. I wanted to get his autograph anyway, so it sucks I didn't get to take a picture, but the drum head was fucking cool. Tracy Lords. Tracy Lords, if y'all don't know, used to be a porn star back in the days, but then she, you know, became an actress. And a movie that was one of my favorites growing up, Cry Baby, with Johnny Depp, Ricky Lake. But met her. She didn't have a line, and so I was like, oh, perfect timing. Walked up, met her. She was super cool. Beautiful still, after all. There it is. I don't know if it froze on your end, but on my end, it was frozen for a second. So I met Tracy Lords. I already had this Executioner Japanese version Castle Freak figure, which is super rare and hard to find, at least not for, you know, way over $100. But can't really tell, but there you go. Got Barbara Crampton and Jeffrey Combs to sign it. So it should be worth a lot more now. Not like it's going anywhere. It's going right back on my full moon wall up high where y'all can't see. They were both cool. Barbara Crampton, beautiful as hell. So then, Mr. Bloody Billy Pond himself, from Circus of the Dead, writer, director, was passing out, you know, posters autographed by all the clowns. I mean, all of them, including Papa Corn himself, Bill O'Burst, which is amazing because I'll never see him at a con. There you go. Billy also signed it. Plus Parrish Randall, who was the victim in the movie and main character. He was there, and that's an awesome dude to hang out with. I got the party with him downstairs about 2 o'clock in the morning on a, I think it was Friday. I don't even remember. Friday or Saturday. And smoked some cigarettes and bullshit. That dude's amazing. Anyway, this was what everybody got, the copies. But I have the actual real one, the original hand, what do you call it, hand-painted water color, whatever, by Dre Molinaire. She's a tattoo artist out there around Odessa, Texas. This thing is cool. So this is actually, you know, the real one painted that the other ones are modeled after. It's also autographed by everybody. If y'all don't know, Billy Pond had cancer, and he was going through some stuff, and he had a little charity. You know, a bunch of people do charity, little different things. But Dre did this one for him. It was an auction, and I won the auction for a highest bidder. So I wanted to make sure that I got it at the con. He was going to mail it to me, but I was like, no, just bring it to the con, and I'll pick it up in person. Billy's a cool-ass dude. I think the only other thing I got at the con was Leaf Jonker, Movie Darkness, comes out, should be coming out around October, to Arrow. Be sure to check that out. This dude's fucking cool as hell. This movie is supposedly badass as hell. So he met us, talked to us, and everything, bullshitted, autographed, poster for us. Y'all make sure y'all check that out around October. I think that's all I got at the con. Now for stuff. Oh, no, hold on. Went over to the Full Moon table. Pretty much already had everything that Full Moon had for sale. But they had these limited edition trading cards for the new Deadly 10 movies coming out. So I did pick up one of these, which these actually, they ran out of these fast. So I'm glad I got them. These are limited edition. I'm not going to open them. But yeah, every card, I guess, has a picture of the movie. One of the different 10 movies, and it tells you about the movie on the back. Now for gifts that I received from some buddies of mine. From my awesome buddy, Darren Mitchell, Horror and Me, who also, you know, is the owner of Serial Resin Co. And he was my roommate. Scored a couple of Demons magnets. I had the original one, you know, that came in the Fright Crate. It was silver. So now I got this ice clear variant. And this, I'm guessing I'll call it like a powder blue. I don't really know. Looks like powder blue. Baby blue, baby powder blue, like kind of like North Carolina. Tar Heel blue. A badass minion. Because I never actually got one of his minions before. So it was cool to snag one. And then, this badass, Ash versus, well, Ash, Dead-Eyed Ash, I should say. This was actually made by Darren. This was some, he was going to give this to fucking Bruce Campbell himself. But Bruce was kind of hard to come by, whether you wanted anything from him. So Bruce never got this, and now I got it. So thank you, Darren. Met the wonderful Victoria Beckin outside. She gave me one of her pins. What else? Oh. My homeboy, my buddy Jordan, Horrorhound 85, brought me this badass, huge fucking goddamn poster of my favorite movie of all time, 1978's Dawn of the Dead. Very cool. He actually brought a poster for me. Did I say Jordan? Why did I say Jordan? Paul, sorry. Paul Slasher Junkie brought me a poster. He brought Jordan a poster. And he brought Darren a poster. So that was badass. Appreciate that, Paul. Check out their channels. I said Horror and Me, Slasher Junkie, Horror Man Cave, Horrorhound 85, Victoria Beckin. Speaking of Horror Man Cave, Eric, he brought me his custom made fucking tick. Look how big this thing is. Huge. Badass. So this is from the movie Ticks. So y'all go check that out. I believe that's about all I got to show y'all. You know, when you're at the con, it feels like there's a whole lot more going on. You get home, you're like, really, that's all I got? Besides an expensive credit card bill and a lot of hangovers. But that's what makes the fun. Anyways, if you ever go to Texas Frightmare Weekend, let me know ahead of time. Hit me up. We'll get some drinks while we're there, because that's pretty much all I do. Y'all be on the lookout for Darren. I shipped off Darren's stuff to him yesterday. I shipped off Paul's a couple days ago. So, Slasher Junkie, Horror and Me, at least them two, make sure you go check out their hauls, TFW hauls they should be doing here in the next week or so. I'm not sure if Jordan's going to do one, but thanks for watching mine. Tell me what you think about everything. Give me a thumbs up. Love y'all, guys. For real.